Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm not sure if this is the first time that I have ever made a keto cooking video, but I'm gonna try today. And what I'm gonna do is my version of a, fried rice, cauliflower fried rice. I have here, I'm just heating off the pan, but before that, let me show you what I have here. From Coles, I've got the Australian cauliflower rice, and there's 300 grams in here, and this was like $3, which I know I can make my own cauliflower rice, but every time that I try to do that, it just turns out like shit, so never mind. Then I have here 75 grams of sliced button mushrooms. Yes, I weigh my food. Okay. I also will be using, this is 55 grams of sweet Australian capsicum and then 50 grams of cucumber. So I've got that sorted out there. I also will be using two large eggs for that. If you want to keep this vegetarian, you can omit the eggs, that's entirely up to you. I'll be using chicken salt, about 5 grams of it, which is like half a teaspoon. Yeah, I think so. Yeah. And then I will be using as well onion flakes, half a teaspoon, and half a teaspoon of garlic powder. Now to put in some fat, I will be using 30 mils of this organic flavor-free coconut oil. I don't really like the taste of coconut oil, so when I saw this from Low Carb Emporium, then I was like, I'm gonna go and get that. So I'll be using that. I'm preheating the pan right now, and then I'll just walk you through what I'm gonna do. You can obviously put some meat if you wanted to, like I was thinking of putting in bacon or some Kransky sausages, but let's see how it goes first, and then I'll decide if I wanted to do that. You can definitely like cut up some meats that you prefer and then add this onto your fried rice. Okay, so now that our pan is hot, I'm gonna first put in, it's hot and it's also got 30 mils of coconut oil in it. I'm gonna first put in the button mushrooms. I'm doing this in the order of how long it takes to cook each ingredient. Okay, so the button mushrooms first. And that's just gonna sizzle away. Okay, so as you can see, that's already sizzling. I'm gonna now pour in the cauliflower rice. Get as much of it out of the packet. And then stir that in. Now the great thing about using coconut oil is that it's a very good source of MCT oil, and this one because it's unflavored, so you don't actually taste the coconut, which I'm not a very big fan of. So here we go, and that's going to cook. Alternatively, you can use you could also use butter to cook your fried rice in. I'm going to let that cook a little bit more. All right, now it's time to stir in the capsicum. And that just adds a beautiful color into our fried rice. Mix that in nicely. This really doesn't take long. I suppose the preps will, cutting up the vegetables and all that stuff. And then lastly, I'll put in the cucumbers. So it's a very festive, like Christmassy color right there. Cucumber is gonna add a little bit of sweetness into the fried rice. And so will the capsicum, because the capsicum is sweet Australian capsicum. If you don't know what that looks like, it's those elongated capsicums. I found mine at Coles. I'm pretty sure it's available in most, if not all, supermarkets. Now at this point, I would like to add my seasoning. So I'm gonna take my little spoon here is half a teaspoon, and I wanna use a teaspoon of each. So I'm just gonna sprinkle that. This is onion flakes. Okay. Can smell it. It's so nice. This is chicken salt. Give it that really nice flavor. And then finally, I'm gonna put in some garlic powder. Obviously, you're going to need to taste this and make sure that it tastes right for you. You can always tweak it a little bit more. Add some salt and pepper if you wanted to. Make sure that you stir this in well so that everything has got flavor. And look at that. The chicken salt has given it a little bit of a yellow glow, if that's what you would like to call it. A little bit of a yellow hue. Okay, so look at that. Look at how pretty that is. Okay, now of course I'm going to make a hole in the center, and I've already pre-whisked my two eggs. And that is what's gonna come in next. Okay, now mix everything in. Look at that. And I just gotta tell you, I wish there was smell-o-vision, because this smells so good. Like, very, very appetizing. And like I said, it's up to you. You can add your own kind of meat if you wanted to, or you can leave the eggs out if you wanted it to be vegetarian. But yeah. That's my beautiful, beautiful cauliflower fried rice. Now this recipe can feed up to 4 people. I mean, I guess it depends on how big your appetite is. But yeah, I calculated it to be able to feed 4 people. There you go.